set that intention to approach each day, no matter what day of the year, we can approach it with peace and kindness, generosity, all the positive spectrum of what's the capability, the possibilities that we have as a human being. So this is what you're doing. I don't need to even tell you these things because you're already doing it. I find very beautiful to see. And so we're carrying on here. We're preparing for our winter retreat. We'll start on the 5th of January, 3 months. So we're gently winding down. Quite a few people are away traveling, visiting family. Also, most of the nuns have traveled to different monasteries to spend the winter period. And so it's very nice to see a flow of people as part of our big family, our Dhamma family. And so, just in case you think there's fewer people here, that's why. So, but we're all doing well. We're all surviving so far. And just encourage all of us to look after each other. Here again, I'm saying things that you're already doing. So it's almost not unnecessary to say. But yeah, let's just keep looking after each other. It's very nice to see everybody, you know, being cautious around. Not sharing things that we don't want to share, like viruses. And so, take care of ourselves. So just to remind people that hopefully there's calendars. Are there still calendars out back? So next year's forced Sangha calendar available. So please take, and if you want to take some to friends, that's what they're there for. They're there to be taken. They're there to be given away. Nothing makes the donor of those calendars, nothing makes them more happy than to know that we've run out. Because then they know people took them. And we don't want to get to June and see a big stack of calendars sitting there. Also Dhamma books. There's all these books back there. So there might be something there that you haven't seen before or you might be interested in. Please help yourself if you wish. And then we're continuing on the weekends with sharing the food after the resident community collects our food. So it's in the cloister, you may have seen, in the walkway. And so we'll ring a bell, somebody will ring a bell. And so we're going to go and collect our food first. When you see us start to come back in, if you want to stay until we come back, that's fine. But when you see us start to come in, then that's your cue to start to gently move outside. And then wait before you collect your food. And then we made the house, we've heated up the conservatory. There's a log fire roaring in there. So you go from the cloister, you walk around the back side of the house, outside. So you get around to the cloister, to the conservatory outside. And then you'll see signs. And then also the shrine room of the house is also available. So you have two warm spaces where you can comfortably eat your meal so that you're not sitting out in the damp, cold weather. And then today is a special day because of a tree planting in memory of Mr. Tanam. And so this is a lovely way to commemorate someone and to create also a memorial that also, just like people, trees are impermanent, but hopefully they'll be there for a long time and a place for people to visit and to recollect the very wholesome and long life of Mr. Tanam. And so, and maybe because the weather, because we've had rain on and off, I would suggest maybe we meet in the covered walkway and then at 12 noon, okay? And if you haven't quite finished eating, then don't worry, just keep eating. Eating is important. And you can get there as soon as after that as comfortable. Okay? And then we'll do that. And so also, for the resident community or anybody to join in, that would be a lovely thing to do. I'm sorry? Okay, that's a good point. So if you happen to miss the rendezvous, if you happen to miss meeting us out here in the cloister, the tree planting itself is happening near the Lumpacha Stupa. near the Shady. So it's a place of honor. Okay, well, without further ado, I'll read. There's a couple of dedications here that I'll read out, and then I'll invite Mapocha Chito to lead us in the Anamotana today. So, as I just mentioned, with dedication today, Dhamma is offered for our father, Mr. Tanam, on his 100th memorial day. So it's been 100 days since his passing. And it says here, as a note, may he realize the path of liberation and attain Nibbana with metta and family. And also it says, offerings have been made, bringing blessings to family, Yannick, Ratanam, Ross, and all family who passed away. Also, who passed away, someone else who passed away 20 years ago, Mrs. Lisa Naksuk. And so keeping those people in mind.
Ha ha.